It's my pleasure to introduce to our Latvian Agile ladies, Elīna, Jakubaņeca and Linda Vītuma, and it's been my pleasure so to work with them for many years, and so probably I was the first which started to preach Agile to them, and so they were very active listeners, and nowadays I think that they are the best Agile managers, project managers, problem solvers in Latvia. Yeah, so please welcome.
Good afternoon. My name is Elīna, and together with my colleague Linda, we are going to tell you hints about how to become agile in public sector of Latvia. This our experience is based on one project which is currently being running, and we are going to tell you what kind of experience we have gotten so far, and also give you hints if you also want to become agile in public sector. A little bit about us. So I'm CEO of the company called EBIT, but I'm also a guest lecturer at Riga Business School in my spare time for a Management Information Systems course. My colleague Linda, whom I have worked for quite a long time, she's a project manager, mainly dealing with public sector projects. And more you can read on our webpage about us and about our company. The project which we are doing is for Ministry of Education and Science, Republic of Latvia. It's been run together by two companies, by Tieto as prime contractor and by EBIT as subcontractor, but we are working together as one development team. The goal of the project is to enhance the existing educational system. And it is a very important project because we are building a functionality which will allow to manage the budget granted for education system of Latvia. This project was started in August 2011, and as you can see, it's quite long because it's planned to be finished in 2013. And well, it is quite a challenge to be agile in Latvian public sector, but there are three reasons why we are pushing it and why we have decided to be agile. The first reason is that it allows to get the customer the best possible system. It means the customer will actually get not what has been requested in the beginning of the project, but what is actually needed. Second thing is that the agile approach makes the go lives much easier. Kind of, if you don't like something, do it more frequently and maybe you will start to like it. And this really shows, and the third thing is that it allows us to identify the problems early in the project stage, not at the very end as it is with waterfall projects. And now I give floor to my colleague.
So, the project status. Actually, we have been presenting this case a couple months ago, and we told how we are working with requirements agile way, how we're transforming requirements for system to user stories. And now we have developed already for 6 months. We have completed 30% of functionality, and this functionality is going in production now, with first date of production 26th of March, and we have 12 months to go, approximately 12 months ago. So this is public sector, it's European financed and have 50 people in supplier's side. Sometimes we talk about agile projects as given, but actually very rarely we talk about how to become agile. And this will be case study presenting how to become agile, and we would like to present you lessons learned so far. The first lesson is seek for opportunities. Sometimes opportunities are hidden behind obstacles, which you can use to take a risk to try something new. For example, deadlines or business cycle activities, especially ones which are important for customer. In our case, I can give two examples. We have 13th of June. Those involved in project know the importance of that date. It's a threat for termination of our agreement. And for example, 1st of September, everybody related to education know what 1st of September means in educational system. And these obstacles you can use to start some agile practices. Sometimes opportunities can be found in agreement or specification. Read your agreement and specification carefully, and you will find that there are a lot of things which are not forbidden. What I suggest that what is not forbidden is allowed, especially in public sector project. For example, you have in specification requirements for system, which is very, very classical approach, waterfall-y approach, but it's not forbidden to transform them in user stories and define acceptance criteria for user stories and organize all development process based on user stories. Or nobody has forbidden you to make demonstrations for client. And the third point is that we, as suppliers and IT professionals, actually have opportunities simply to start doing it. Nobody should allow us. We simply can start to do it. And which means leading by doing. You start, customer will follow. Just start and look what happens. Then adjust your behavior and then continue. The same demonstrations. We went to customer and said, maybe you would like that we make demonstrations on functionality. And customer said, yes, and we started demonstrations. For example, when there was very tight schedule in a phase go live, we wanted to start updates on daily basis. And we said to customer, maybe you would like to join our daily status update. And customer said, no. And that's also fine, because after some time, they maybe will join. For example, retrospectives. We started internally, and then we said, okay, maybe you would like to join us. And customer said, okay, we can think about that. That's how you seek opportunities and simply start. In summary, deadlines, especially important one for customer, are great opportunities. Not forbidden means allowed in public sector projects especially. And sometimes, especially in public sector, these formal obstacles, for example, agreement, law, absolutely excellent opportunity to start doing something, some prioritization or go live, some related to law or financing terms, they all are motives to become agile. The second lesson is start small. There are two main approaches how you can become agile. One is called start tall, and another is called start small. Starting goal can be scary, and it can build resistance both in customer and supplier side. By implementing practice by practice, starting small, actually you give yourself time and give time to customer to gain trust and to build confidence in both sides. What does it mean in practical life, starting small? Start with simple practices, demonstrations, weekly workshops, which you can use for planning, weekly workshops, which you can use for retrospectives. You can define what done means in your project. This is also agile practice. You can define user stories. You can define acceptance criteria for user stories. That's how you, step by step, practice by practice, becoming agile. I should say that even one person is enough to start being agile, especially if this one person is in customer side, and especially if this person is the main user. And in our project, we get lucky We have such a person, and she is the main user. And actually, we are very lucky because we have more than one person. We have a couple, a number of persons who are open to try something new, maybe because of these formal obstacles. They had this motivation to do that. One more suggestion is look for situations when you can compare different approaches, for example, waterfall or agile, to define or name benefits you can get from each approach. And then you can compare, you can show this to customers. Sometimes customer himself see these differences. And then you can choose what's important for you and for your customer. And one more time, lead by doing. Sometimes, especially at the beginning, it is worse to do something instead of customer, simply to show how it's done. For example, you can define user stories or acceptance criteria or show what product owner's responsibility means. And in our case, for the first release, we have defined user stories ourselves and we have defined acceptance criteria. Now, when this functionality is going in production, we had retrospective and the customer also participated in this retrospective and they said, you know, actually these acceptance criteria were not exactly the way we would like them to be. And maybe we would like next time make these acceptance criteria ourselves. And we said, great, that's the way how it should be. So we'll see how it will work. Start with simple practices, implement them step by step and be consistent. When you start something, keep doing it until in some retrospective, you will find that it's not working in your project, then you will drop this practice. Then add next practice, then next practice, next practice. Even one person is enough to start, compare different practices to name benefits, lead by doing, just start, and customer will follow. And in summary of second lesson, I should say, call whatever you want. Just start being agile. Internally, practice by practice, stop talking, start doing. The third lesson sounds absolutely great. Work harder. When you start using agile practices in software development, you should be ready that it will be time consuming. You will need focus and deliver. And you should be committed to make your contribution to the project success, where the only measurement of success is working software in production. Lack of commitment for whatever reason or justification, for example, typical justifications, lack of understanding, complexity of approach chosen, a lack of trust of the supplier, we don't trust you, or we had very bad experience previous time, actually may hide bigger problems underneath. It's an insufficient ability to deliver. And this statement applies to both sides, customer and supplier. If you are not willing to use Agile, maybe it's because you are not able to deliver. What does hard worker, how hard worker looks from customer side, how we have seen that? Customer will be asked to check in depth all deliverables since they are delivered in small relevant portions. If I have written any piece of paper, I will ask you read it and test it and accept it. It means work. In 2 week period, which is our sprint, 2 hours of planning and retrospective, 2 hours of demonstration, every other day 2 hours in workshops on particular topics, which is approximately 60 hours face-to-face meeting. Customer is asked to make very detailed testing, functionality, documentation, specification, acceptance criteria, which also my estimate is approximately 16 hours per sprint, which means in 2 week period, approximately 32 hours
what is 40% of time, customer is asked to devote undivided attention to the project. And also every user story, or in our case requirement, have its owner who is responsible for acceptance criteria definition, testing, and making decision on acceptance. We all want results, and we can get them sometimes when we work harder, but sometimes, especially in public sector projects, simply when we start working with focus to the working software in production. So, be committed to make your contribution to the project, where the only measurement is working software in production. Be ready to solve problem, which most probably will be evident, which is called insufficient ability to deliver in both sides. Plan at least 40% of project time will be devoted in close, most probably face-to-face cooperation, and work harder, or simply start working.
So, the official mean of communication in public sector projects are letters. If the customer or supplier wants to exchange the information which is extremely important to the project, they write each other a letter. We also want to share with you some very important information, so that is why we have written three letters. The first letter is for the consultants which are working on customer side. The second letter is for the customer, and the third letter is for the supplier. The aim of these letters are to explain how we can help each other to become agile in public sector projects. Dear consultant, you are an extremely important person, and extremely important because you are involved already in pre-project phase and in bid preparation. So you are actually laying the foundation of the project, and if you do it improperly, then actually the whole project is under great risk. So please write the requirements in form of user stories or agile or other agile friendly way, because the customer is willing to test particular activities and processes. So what we have seen in public sector projects is that already in the bid document we get the requirements which are not agile friendly, which are focused on system but not actually on functionality or the activities which a customer has to perform. It makes very hard for us to develop them, and lately in the later stages of the project it is very hard for the customer to test them. So please think about including the information in requirement stage about who does what with what purpose. And the purpose is especially important because the customer wants to understand where that particular requirement fits into the organizational processes. I can give you an example that in one of our latest projects there was a requirement to develop a search possibility, but we couldn't find any information who would like to look at those data and what actually needs to be searched. So if you would write the requirements in agile friendly way, this wouldn't happen, because then you would be able to identify in early stages that this particular requirement doesn't fit into the process and nobody actually needs it. Second thing what we would like to ask is, please define clear acceptance criteria for the processes performed within the system together with the customer. In Agile, it is extremely important to understand what is done. So when we can consider that the software is actually working and that the software has been completed. So you must define the clear acceptance criteria. And what we see now in public sector bid cases is that there are requirements like we can go live if there are no priority one issues and not more than 10 priority two issues. But that's not an acceptance criteria, because you can build a really lousy software without any error in it. So when you write acceptance criteria, please write the way in a way that we can verify that the software is fit for the purpose and that actually it meets the needs of the customer. And please do it together with the customer, because the customer must understand what they are ordering actually. Dear customer, the IT projects are meant to build tools for you so you can do your job more easily and that you can reach your goals. So please set the goals for the project and acceptance criteria and document them before the project. So this also goes together with the approach in Agile that the only criteria for success is working software. So these goals and acceptance criteria actually are the targets which we need to reach by doing the IT project. System is not ready when you have a pile of documents and the source code, but system is ready when you have reached your goal. Please use your resources wisely. Agile approach gives you a wonderful opportunity to easily change the scope of the project if you see that some requirements are not needed anymore. So we all know that it often happens that at the beginning of the project we think that we need one thing, but during the project we actually find out that there are other things which are much more important. So use this opportunity which is given by Agile and use your time and money wisely. Replace the unneeded requirements with the ones you actually need. Prioritize and analyze and make the decisions. And don't be afraid to make the decision to change the scope. Please be ready to change. The thing that some things are being done for many years in one way, it doesn't mean that they are right. Things are changing, and please accept it and seek for opportunities and use them for your own favor. And Agile is one of the opportunities which you should learn to use. Dear supplier, you are actually the one which is setting the target and which is actually setting the level how agile the project will be. So please do not give up being agile or becoming agile. It is very hard at the moment in public sector to be agile or to become agile, and you will meet a resistance. You will have to build up your technical excellence. You will have to learn a lot, but please don't stop doing it, because actually you are the one who can push the process and who can become agile and start with yourself. And please note that there is only one measure of success: working error-free software in production. All the other things are irrelevant, and all the documents, they don't mean nothing, but they are not working software. And if you change your mindset to this one, that the only thing is working software, then you will notify the problems in your project very early, not at the very late stage of the project. And it will help you to solve the problems as they come, not postpone them till later. So these were all lessons which we learned. And thank you for listening. So any questions?
Hello. You have mentioned in the beginning the laws. So I have one question. Is there any law in Latvia which defines how to create IT projects for public sector? For example, define that you can use only waterfall process, or you can use waterfall, agile, and whatever processes. Thank you.
I think there are some regulation on IT project, but I suppose there is no strict regulation what method you should use. What I meant by saying laws is related to business processes. For example, if there is law that some functionality should be implemented in production in the date of 5th of March, then it's your opportunity to try to suggest for customer, maybe we can make priorities, or maybe we can split some functionality in shorter term and deliver
that's a way, how I said that formal obstacles can be used as possibilities or motives to become agile. Or, for example, define what's done mean for this functionality, which need be done, need be in production in 5th of March.
Yes, how do you sell an agile project in a public tender?
We pretend we are not agile. It's a half truth, because we are describing there is in public sector, there is part public proposals, there is part where you should describe what approach you will use, and we describe agile approach there, and then we try to survive.
How do you mitigate the risk that a governmental employee asks you to do less because you said that working software will be more expensive, but it will have fewer features, therefore you have to take some of your wishes off the list? How do you mitigate the risks that government gets good result? What he first asked, like in this request of proposal?
This also is the case, if I understood correctly, question is the case of survival. We are trying to survive between specification and really valuable working software. And this risk we are mitigating through these face-to-face meetings. And actually, it's maybe will sound very strangely, but we have very good documentations on our workshops also, on what we have agreed in each workshop.
Because the dangerous part is Ingo and Sudraba that will come and ask, you asked this and this, and why didn't you know that you don't have to ask this, and it's not maybe so good concurrence, yes.
Okay. I call in Latvia we have very developed one practice which called fair-based development, fair-driven development, yes. That's very good reason not to be agile, of course, but still it's worth trying, and at least you can minimize the invaluable software. So don't be afraid, simply try.
One more question. How do you think, I don't know, you have the experience, what is the biggest impediment for the companies to make IT projects for the public sector in agile way? Because you said that you write, you'll do in agile way and you're trying to survive. Was the lack of knowledge or something? What do you think it is?
You mean what are the obstacles for? Hard to say, actually, because we don't see them. We just go and try to work in agile way.
You said that you come to client and you have to explain, and for example, when you write the public tenders, you are also write that you do in agile way and you are trying to survive. So there are some obstacles and other companies doesn't do this.
Okay.
This way. So how do you think they don't do this?
So the majority of these tenders are just copy-paste.
Yes, I think the knowledge, the problem is the knowledge.
It's copy-paste is easy.
So I know, but
you're right. Actually, the main obstacle is lack of information, lack of knowledge, lack of experience, because it's always hard to start something new. And I think you also heard in previous presentation that it's, you have to get a critical mass before agile comes a normal practice which is accepted everywhere. And in Latvian public sector it just starts to arrive, because as Linda also told, when you see two projects running in parallel, one with in waterfall methodology, the other with agile practice, you see that the first project after 6 months time or 3 months time have delivered you pile of documentation, but the other project has delivered already working software, okay, not all of it, but you already have a release. So you can try and feel how the software looks in production. And when the customer has two projects running in parallel, it's pretty obvious which practice is better.
I would comment also that I think in Latvia there is very, very popular thinking both in supplier and customer side, which is called win-lose. Somebody always lose. And actually with Agile, we are trying to introduce new thinking, which is called win-win. And nobody believes us. And we are trying to survive, because in relationship, when some we are thinking that it's possible to work win-win, and our partner or our customer thinks that in our relationships always somebody lose, they are making us to lose, and that's why we should survive, and it's not easy. Still, we hope maybe Latvian society also in some time will become more educated and more mature to be able on relationships related on win-win.
What's your experience? How do you deal with the risk that customer representative don't care about success of that project?
We escalate that, and we are trying to make it as visible as it's possible. And there is a moment, because it's true, especially in public sector, and we are trying to make best part of our job, and then we simply stop. And we are waiting. And for example, in a particular situation in the project, we said that we will not continue to start work on new requirements until we will go in production with this release. And we have stopped, full stop. And it motivated customer to solve their problems.
Any other questions? Okay, there is one.
What about documentation? Because Agile suggests that working software first, but comprehensive documentation is less important. But public sector usually wants thorough documentation instead, but together with the software. Thanks.
Okay, so in our case, it goes together. We are starting work both on product, on functionality and on documentation. And in our project, done means where there is working software and documentation. And release is delivered when also documentation is delivered. So we respect. Working software has first priority, but we respect that documentation also is needed, and we are preparing the piles of that.
And customer is actually very happy for the opportunity that they can read this document together and with checking the software, so they don't have like 200 pages up front, but they get some 20 pages together with working software, so they can compare what has been programmed and what has been delivered as a documentation.
And in our case also, we are lucky because there is one parallel project in Waterfall, and customer can see benefit if there is smaller documentation together with functionality working software instead of very big document without software.